It's news time. Information is power. The current. The news headline. Bandits attacks 10 students killed, 780 abducted, 61 in captivity, Amnesty International. The news in full. As the year bubbles to an end, horrible security statistics been rolling out by global watchdog, Amnesty International shows that children in Nigeria have become the major attacks by bandits. In a statement on Thursday, the organization claimed 780 children have been abducted, 10 school children killed, and 61 in custody. No child should go through what children are going through now in education. Education should not be a matter of life and death for anyone. Nigeria is failing children once again in a horrifying manner, says Osai Ujigo, director of Amnesty International Nigeria. Knocking the authorities for allegedly failing the Nigerian child, Amnesty said Nigerian authorities are failing children as at least 61 children in northern Nigeria remain in captivity months after the abduction during mass attacks on schools, which also terminated the education of thousands of children while putting children in captivity through horrific and degrading treatment in the hands of bandits. Children in orphanages, schools, and places of worship are often abducted and held in captivity for weeks, sometimes months, depending on when or if the demands of the abductors are met. Children in school buses or walking to schools are only sometimes ambushed and abducted for ransom. Ujigo stated that school children in some parts of northern Nigeria are constantly at the risk of death or abduction. More than 780 children have been abducted for ransom since February 2021 during attacks on schools or religious institutions. Therefore, it is sacrosanct for the federal government of Nigeria to see how to stop all these abductions, especially at this period in time.
Terrorizing the southeast part of Nigeria, MEFO was reacting to a statement last week by IPOB, where it warned unknown gunmen killing innocent people in the southeast to desist forthwith. According to MEFO via its known Facebook page, the spirit of Igboland is angry. It criticized outlawed IPOB for its pretentious hypocritical damage control. Unknown gunmen declares war against unknown gunmen. What a tragedy. We warned you that your reckless utterances, ill-advised, ill-conceived, self-inflicted, self-destructive campaign of horror and violence in Biafra land would lead to anarchy, lawlessness, and proliferation of armed militia groups. In the struggle for restoration of Biafra, all hands must be on deck. What goes up must come down. Remember this statement, is it a magic that all of you who lied against me and others are all lying against yourselves, including your leader? The spirit of the land is angry with all of you. When you ignore strategists on strategic advice on issues like this and of this magnitude, the consequences are bound to be indeterminate. And these are the words of Uche Mefo, the leader of the estranged deputy leader of the Indigenous People of Biafra, IPOB, who had actually said on Tuesday that the secessionist movement are unknown gunmen terrorizing the southeast part of Nigeria.
Whether he and his family members listen or not, I will continue to counsel him. I will continue to counsel him as I have done in the past. What we do need is a most peaceful and secured society. But Kanu's family, in a swift reaction, lampooned the former governor, accusing him of unnecessarily advertising his visit to Kanu, probably for political gains. Kanu's younger brother, Prince Emmanuel Kanu, who spoke for the family, demanded explanations from the governor what he meant by Kanu's insane amount of people rooting for his release. The family cautioned the Senator Ojikalu want to achieve by those confusing and disparaging remarks. Is it saying that the millions of followers of Nnamdi Kanu who feel disenchanted by the protracted and provocative marginalization and injustice perpetrated against Biafrans by the Nigerian authority are insane? Who is Kanu working for? Must he advertise his visits to our brother If he thinks he has any solution to prefer, can't be work from behind the scene, must he make political capital of every issue? We are highly disappointed by his incoherent utterances. He must understand that our brother is not being prosecuted because he stole or committed a crime. His only crime is that it's a crime for asking for the freedom of people, of the oppressed people of Biafra. Oji, Uzo, Kalu and his types are the reason the agitation for self-determination by our people is unending. How can he be trusted by the people? We have not forgotten his role in 2017 when our brother was in Kuje prison. What is his mission? Is it for or against Nnamdi Kanu? By his utterances, it is clear that he is no solution but part of the problems of our people. He shouldn't forget that history will judge him for all his actions and inactions. In case Kanu doesn't know, real Igbo leaders are working behind the scene to bring about solution to the problem of our people. They don't make noise over it, he said. And this is the news that Mazi Nnamdi Kanu had actually, been visited by Senator Oji Kalu, who actually made some remarks that got vexed to the family of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, who said that the comments of Oji Uzo Kalu about the followers of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu to be insane amount of people, saying that the utterances of Oji Uzo Kalu was clearly no solutions but part of the problems of the people, saying that he needs not to forget that history will judge him for all his actions and inactions, especially that they have not forgotten his role in 2017 when their brother was in Kuje prison, saying that what is his mission, that they need to know clearly if he is for or against Nnamdi Kanu, reiterating that Kanu was actually not arrested for a crime or for stealing. All he was arrested for was because he was fighting for the oppressed people of Biafra. The Movement for the Actualization of the Sovereign State of Biafra, MASOB, has celebrated the release of 19 of their members who have been detained since 2006. The celebration coincided with 10 years anniversary of the death of Igbo leader Dim Chukwuemeka Odumegwu Ojukwu, Eze Igbo Gburugburu. In a statement, MASOB leader Uchenna Madu described Dim Chukwuemeka Odumegwu Ojukwu as the greatest Igbo man that has ever lived. The statement reads in part, Dim Chukwuemeka still remains the greatest Nigerian man that ever lived. He laid an unforgettable foundation for enhancement and restoration of true Africanism and total liberation of black man from Western domination. Ojukwu was the president of Biafra and the general of the People's Army. He stood for justice, total freedom, and equity for us all. We are celebrating a living legend, a symbol of Igboism, the lion that is fear conquers the enemy of his people.